Now, as we just studied, photosystem first responds to a wavelength of 700 nanometers. It responds to a wavelength of 700 nanometers. Photosystem second responds to a wavelength of 680 nanometers. This is requiring higher energy, as energy is inversely proportional to wavelength. Energy of light is inversely proportional to the wavelength of the light. Right? Okay. So 680 nanometers means it would be requiring more energy, and 700 nanometers means it would be requiring lesser energy. It would be requiring lesser energy. Okay. So if lesser energy is available, only PS1 is active, so cyclic flow occurs. So cyclic flow occurs, which does not create a deficiency in PS1, deficiency of electrons in PS1. But whenever high energy is available, both of these systems are active. Once PS2 is active, right, and electrons flow on non-cyclic pathway, electrons are flowing on non-cyclic pathway, right, electrons of PS2 enter PS1, and finally they are accepted by NADP. This is happening. Okay. Definitely, electrons from PS2 also reach its primary electron acceptor, just like the primary electron acceptor of the PS1. Now, this non-cyclic pathway of electrons, or the non-cyclic movement of this electron, creates a deficiency of electrons in this system, PS2. And this deficiency is compensated by photolysis of the water. Four water molecules would break, generating four protons and four OH negative ions. It has additional amount of electrons. Now, these electrons are taken up by PS2, and the system goes on. The system goes on working like this. From PS2 to the primary electron acceptor, then to PS1, then to the primary electron acceptor of the PS1 to the NADP positive, right? These four OH negative, these ions are rearranged to form two water molecules and one oxygen molecule is released in this process. These two water molecules are recycled. दोबारा use में आ जाएंगे. And this oxygen escapes out through these stomata into the air. Now, why to write 4H2O over here? Simply because it is the molecular oxygen which is produced. It is the molecular oxygen which is produced. अगर हम यहाँ पे नंबर हाफ कर दें, इफ आई राइट 2H2O ओवर हियर, द नंबर ऑफ O2, दिस वुड बिकम हाफ, दिस O2 वुड बिकम हाफ, एंड दिस वुड बिकम एटॉमिक ऑक्सीजन और नेसेंट ऑक्सीजन व्हिच इज नॉट रिलीज्ड इन फोटोसिंथेसिस. इन द प्रोसेस ऑफ फोटोसिंथेसिस इट इज द मॉलिक्यूलर ऑक्सीजन व्हिच इज रिलीज्ड. सो द मिनिमम नंबर ऑफ वाटर मॉलिक्यूल्स अंडरगोइंग फोटोलिसिस वुड बी four water molecules, which will generate four electrons over here, right? Okay, and in this process, when the electrons are passing through a series of electron acceptors, ATP is produced. This is light reaction. Right. Now we have to understand the exact position with respect to thylakoids, where all these things are happening. Now, let this be the membrane of thylakoid. Thylakoid is a single membrane bound structure. Thylakoid is a single membrane bound structure. It doesn't have two membranes. Right. This is the outer surface of the membrane. This is the outer surface. Outer surface. And this is the inner surface. This would be the inner surface. The inner surface. Right. Okay. Let this be the oppressed surface. This be oppressed surface. So there is PS1 and PS2 both. Here is this PS1. The electrons flow cyclically. The electrons flow cyclically. यहां से इलेक्ट्रॉन प्राइमरी एक्सेप्टर के पास गए. And from the electron, from this primary electron acceptor, the electrons now move towards a hydrogen carrier. There is a compound over here, right? And from this hydrogen carrier, the electrons are again returned back to PS1. This is happening in this membrane only, right? Let this be PS2. Again, everything is happening in the membrane itself. Again, everything is happening in the membrane itself. The electrons would move towards its primary electron acceptor. Right. And from this primary electron acceptor, the electrons would move towards this hydrogen carrier. This is hydrogen carrier. And then from this hydrogen carrier, the electrons, these additional electrons reach PS1. And then these electrons move out of the thylakoid into the stroma. This space is the stroma. This is the stroma. These would move into the stroma, right? The electrons, when released towards the stromal surface, towards the stroma, they are accepted by a substance that is NADP. NADP kahan pe hai? NADP is in the stroma. Right? Now let us talk about this substance. This substance. This is the hydrogen carrier. Hydrogen carrier. This hydrogen carrier. This hydrogen carrier is a compound known as plastoquinone, written in short PQ. PQ, the full form, PQ is plastoquinone. Has ketone group. It's basically a diene. It is basically a diene. Isme do ketone groups hain. Like for example, there is a carbon chain. So this carbon is attached having this oxygen. Then again a carbon chain in between, and there is another ketone group. Right. Now, when it accepts the electron, what happens? One electron, one negative charge. Another electron, another negative charge. Another electron, negative charge, negative charge. Right. Now, whenever this happens, right. What it can do is, electrons could be received here only. Whenever this happens, on these sides, it can receive protons. It can receive protons. Right. Now, whenever negative charge develops here, even here, it can receive protons. Even on these sides, to be single bond ho jayega, to carbon ki valency to satisfy karne ke liye yahan electron aur yahan pe protons aa jayenge. So in this manner, it actually shows a transition from the state of being dione. It forms a diol. Diol. From the state of being dione, it becomes diol. And this diol, being unstable, is again reverted back to the state of dione. Right? It received electrons from PS1. Right, and then accepted protons from the outside. So at the level of this carrier, at the level of this, you would observe that it is accepting hydrogen. Electron yahan se, protons stroma se. Iske level pe aapko kya mila? H. Theek hai. Because this diol is unstable, it acts as a proton pump. It releases protons into the lumen of the thylakoid. Now this is the cavity or the lumen. This is the lumen of the thylakoid. Lumen of thylakoid, right? And whenever deficiency of electrons in PS2 would occur and photolysis would occur to generate these four electrons in the lumen of thylakoids. Where does photolysis occur? In the lumen of thylakoids. Whenever photolysis of the water occurs to generate electrons for photosystem. Second, at the same time, protons are being produced. Right? So, whenever electrons are moving, protons are being pumped into the thylakoid, into the lumen of the thylakoid by this hydrogen carrier. Whenever jab bhi electrons move karenge to kya hoga, protons andar ko pump ho rahe honge, chahe PS1 kaam kare chahe PS2 kaam kare. PS1 agar kaam karega to bhi iske paas electron protons aayenge aur wo protons lumen of the thylakoid mein release ho jayenge. PS2 जब काम करेगा तो एक तरफ उसके इलेक्ट्रॉन्स जब इस पंप के पास आएंगे, हाइड्रोजन कैरियर के पास आएंगे, तो भी ये प्रोटॉन्स को पंप कर रहा होगा. दूसरी चीज, PS2 जो है, PS2 में डेफिशिएंसी ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन्स को कंपेंसेट करने के लिए फोटोलिसिस ऑफ द वाटर जब होगा तो एडिशनल प्रोटॉन्स यहां पे बन जाएंगे. नाउ दीज प्रोटॉन्स एग्जिट एट पर्टिकुलर साइट्स. The membrane of the thylakoid is otherwise impermeable to the membrane except at these sites. These protons leave the lumen of the thylakoids due to an electrochemical gradient and they enter the stroma. And whenever this happens, ATP is produced. ATP is produced. ATP is produced in the stomach. ADP plus inorganic phosphate. राइट right. अभी प्रोटॉन्स यहां पे इकट्ठे होने शुरू होंगे. अगर प्रोटॉन्स यहां पे इकट्ठे होने शुरू हो जाएंगे तो इनर एस्पेक्ट ऑफ द मेम्ब्रेन वुड बिकम पॉजिटिवली चार्ज्ड. द इनर सरफेस बिकम्स पॉजिटिव चार्ज्ड. यहां पे पॉजिटिव चार्ज आ जाएगा प्रोटॉन्स की वजह से. इधर बना देते हैं, यहां पॉजिटिव चार्ज आ गया इनर मेम्ब्रेन की सरफेस पे और यहां डेफिशिएंसी ऑफ द पॉजिटिव चार्ज है. यहां पे नेगेटिव चार्ज कर दो आप, द मेम्ब्रेन बिकेम पोलर. अ ग्रेडियंट इज एस्टैब्लिश्ड, इलेक्ट्रोकेमिकल ग्रेडियंट इज एस्टैब्लिश्ड बिटवीन द टू सरफेसेस ऑफ द थायरॉइड मेम्ब्रेन. एज अ रिजल्ट द प्रोटॉन्स बिगिन टू मूव आउट. एज द प्रोटॉन्स मूव आउट एटीपी इज प्रोड्यूस्ड. जैसे जैसे प्रोटॉन्स मूव करेंगे वैसे वैसे एटीपी बनता चला जाएगा. This complete is triggered by sunlight. PS1 पे sunlight fall की, PS1 का electron cyclically घूमा, electrons इस hydrogen carrier के पास आया, hydrogen carrier ने protons को stoma से लिया और stoma से वापस अंदर को भेज दिया, into the lumen of thyroid, यहाँ भेज दिया. PS2 का electron इसके पास आया, इसने फिर protons को बाहर अंदर की तरफ pump कर दिया. PS2 में deficiency of electrons हुई, photolysis of the water हुआ, protons की concentration और बढ़ गई. जैसे जैसे protons pump किए जाएंगे या photolysis of the water होगा, दोनों ही conditions में अंदर की तरफ protons की concentration बढ़नी शुरू हो जाएगी. protons की concentration अंदर बढ़ेगी, thylakoid की membrane polarized हो जाएगी, अंदर की तरफ positive, बाहर की तरफ negative. electrochemical gradient develop हो जाएगा. इस इलेक्ट्रोकेमिकल ग्रेडियंट को तोड़ने के लिए ठीक है प्रोटॉन्स बाहर मूव करेंगे. जब प्रोटॉन्स बाहर मूव करेंगे तो एटीपी बन जाएगा. दीज प्रोटॉन्स इन टर्न आर एक्सेप्टेड बाय एनएडीपी. एनएडीपी ऑन वन साइड इज एक्सेप्टिंग इलेक्ट्रॉन्स एंड फ्रॉम वन साइड इट इज एक्सेप्टिंग प्रोटॉन्स. द रिजल्ट इज एनएडीपी एच टू इज प्रोड्यूस्ड. जिसको हम इस तरह से लिख देते हैं NADPH, H पॉजिटिव हम इस तरह से लिख देते हैं. ठीक है, ये हम लिख दिया NADPH2. NADPH2 कहां बना? स्ट्रोमा में. ATP कहां बना? स्ट्रोमा में. ठीक, लेकिन NADPH2 सिर्फ तब बनेगा जब PS2 के इलेक्ट्रॉन्स या PS2 का एक्साइटेशन होगा. NADPH2 would be formed only when PS2 is excited, because then only there would be excess of electrons moving from PS1 towards the stroma, towards NADP in the stroma. Right? This is light reaction with respect to or in relation to the thylakoid membrane, and this includes chemi-osmotic hypothesis as well.